You spent 2 days this week, I think, in Sydney and Melbourne, quizzing business leaders on these company tax cuts. What impressions did you form?
I chose to take part in the inquiry because since the rising of the Senate in late March, in which I indicated my position, I've undertaken, at the request of the government, further examination of the modelling and also meeting with stakeholders and other economists. I took part on Tuesday and Thursday to hear more of that and also to hear from the Business Council of Australia itself and some of its member companies. From this process, I remain to be convinced that the proposal or the tax bill, as is, should gather my support. I see the benefits as still being modest relative to the cost, and in the face of the budget deficit and overall government debt, I do not think that it's prudent to undertake it in isolation from other tax reform.
So when you say you remain to be convinced, is that it? Have you made up your mind, or is there something that might still persuade you?
My approach is to evaluate bills as put before me. There's no indication from the government to me that they wish to undertake a different bill other than what was put at the end of March. So that's why I am still remain to be convinced in its current form of my support.
Okay, so you're generally making a judgment on the merits of the bill. You're not looking for some sort of trade-off, something for South Australia?
No. My key to my approach that I've said in the Senate and in publicly is that I'll be evaluating bills on their merits in an evidence-based framework. This is what I think is expected of me as a senator from South Australia, to evaluate bills in terms of principles of integrity, sustainability, prosperity and fairness for the people of South Australia and all Australians in general, and not to engage in a trade-off process for my support.
All right, if that's your position, then I guess the pressure will really come on Senators Patrick and Griff in South Australia. There were reports that maybe they're starting to make more positive noises. What sense are you getting of their position?
I think ultimately you have to ask them their position. Senator Patrick took part in the inquiry in Melbourne on the Thursday. He asked questions of the Business Council regarding overall tax reform, and in particular one of the petroleum resource rent tax. But I have no indication of their position or what the government are saying to them. I've just been engaging with the government directly and undertaking my own process of review of the bills, and that's what I did this week as well.
All right, can I just ask you finally, Tony Shepherd, who's a former president of the Business Council, described some of the questioning at this inquiry as bordering on harassment. How did you see it?
I saw it as robust, and I think that is appropriate because it's a significant bill. It's $35.6 billion. And so I think the Business Council itself and its member companies put that commitment to the Senate of their own volition. They weren't asked to. So therefore, I think they needed to be prepared to defend it vigorously, and I think that's what occurred.
Tim Storer, thanks for your time. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much, Barry.